In this lecture, we'll be discussing about the design of transformer tank with cooling tubes. We have to provide cooling tubes over the transformer tank walls in order to improve the heat dissipation. So we have to calculate the number of tubes to be provided as well as the arrangement of tubes, how these tubes can be arranged over the tank surface. So let us see. So by providing the cooling tubes, we are actually increasing the heat dissipating surface area. So the provision of tubes increases the heat dissipating surface area. So heat dissipation will naturally increase. But the increase in heat dissipation is not proportional to the increase in area. Ethra area koodunno, athrayum thanne heat dissipation koodathilla. Because when we are providing the tubes over the tank surface, some of the surface area of the tank will be screened by this tube. So we are actually providing the tube over the tank surface. So this tube will screen, it will cover some of the dissipating surface area of the transformer tank. So this prevents radiation of heat, radiation from that particular tank, particular portion of tank surface. So that is why it has been said that the increase in heat dissipation is not proportional to increase in area. But the heat dissipation due to convection actually increases. Heat dissipation due to convection increases with the provision of tubes. Okay. But there is a reduction in the heat dissipation due to radiation. That is why we are saying that increase in dissipation is not proportional to increase in area. Area etra koodunno, athrayum thanne dissipation koodunnilla. Because radiation korayunnundu as the tubes are screening some of the tank surface. But the heat dissipation due to convection increases due to the circulation of oil through the tubes. Actually, this cooling tubes carries oil. Cooling oil. So cooling oil improves convection. So heat dissipation due to convection increases with the provision of cooling tubes. And it is found that the heat dissipation due to convection improves by 35% more than that without the tubes. So convection improves by 35% more. So tubes provide ചെയ്തു കഴിഞ്ഞാൽ പിന്നുള്ള കൺവെക്ഷൻ ഓൾറെഡി ഉണ്ടായിരുന്ന കൺവെക്ഷൻ കാരണമുള്ള ഹീറ്റ് ഡിസിപ്പേഷനേക്കാളും 35% കൂടുതലായിരിക്കും. ദാറ്റ് ഈസ് 135% ആവും. സോ ദി പ്രൊവിഷൻ ഓഫ് ട്യൂബ്സ് ഇംപ്രൂവ്സ് കൺവെക്ഷൻ ബൈ 35% മോർ ദാൻ ദാറ്റ് വിതൗട്ട് ദ ട്യൂബ്സ്. സോ നൗ ലെറ്റ് അസ് ഡിറൈവ് ദ എക്സ്പ്രഷൻ ഫോർ ദ നമ്പർ ഓഫ് ട്യൂബ്സ് ടു ബി യൂസ്ഡ്. So we have already taken ST as the surface area of the transformer tank. We have taken ST as the heat dissipating surface area of the transformer tank. Now, the dissipating surface area of the tubes, we can take it as X into ST. It is a fraction of ST. X times ST. X will be a constant which is less than 1. So dissipating surface area of the tank is ST and that of the tubes is X into ST. So now we can write the total heat dissipating surface area. So total heat dissipating surface area will be equal to the surface area of the tank plus the surface area of the tube. That is ST plus X into ST. That means 1 plus X into ST. So total heat dissipating surface area after providing the tubes will be equal to 1 plus X into ST. So now total heat dissipation due to convection and radiation from the tank. So tank dissipates heat by both radiation as well as convection. So total heat dissipation from the transformer tank due to radiation and convection, it will be 6 plus 6.5. So what is 6 plus 6.5? It is the specific heat dissipation. 6 is the specific heat dissipation due to radiation and 6.5 is the specific heat dissipation due to convection. So these are the specific heat dissipation, and here we are writing the total heat dissipation. So specific heat dissipation means it is expressed in watt per meter square degree Celsius. That is heat dissipation from a unit area. So total heat dissipation means the heat dissipation from the entire surface. So it will be equal to specific heat dissipation into total area, total heat dissipating area. So that means we'll get it as 12.5 into ST. So specific heat dissipation from the transformer tank surface is 12.5, and the total heat dissipation, that is heat dissipation from the entire surface, will be specific heat dissipation into total area, that is 12.5 ST. And we have also said that the provision of tubes improves the convection. When tubes are provided, heat dissipation due to convection increases. Tubes dissipates heat by convection. So that heat dissipation, total heat dissipated due to convection by the tubes. So we know that heat dissipated due to convection is 6.5. Before providing the tubes, the heat dissipation due to convection is 6.5. And before, we have stated that with the provision of tubes, the heat dissipation due to convection improves by 35% more than that without the tubes. So tube provide cheythu kayumbo ulla convection, tube kodukkunnathinu munpu undayirunna convection ekkalum 35% koodum. That is currently adu 135% aavum. So this is the value of specific heat dissipation without the tubes. So when tubes are provided, it increases by 35%. That is 6.5 into 135 divided by 100. Okay, this is the total heat dissipation. Sorry, specific heat dissipation. And we are writing the expression for total heat dissipation. So total heat dissipation will be equal to specific into total area. So area of the tubes, we have taken it as X into ST. So on multiplying 6.5 into 135 by 100, we will get it as 8.8. So this will be 8.8 into X into ST. Okay. So this is the heat dissipation from the tank. We know that tank dissipates heat by radiation and convection. By radiation, 6 watt per meter square degree Celsius. By convection, 6.5 watt per meter square degree Celsius. And in total, 12.5 watt per meter square degree Celsius. So total heat dissipation from the entire surface, it will be 12.5 into ST. And the tubes dissipates heat by convection, and the convection improves by 35% more than that without tubes. The tube koduthu kayumbulla convection, tube kodukkunnathinu munpulla convection value nekkalum 35% increase. So 6.5 into 135 by 100 into, in order to get the total heat dissipation, we have to multiply specific heat dissipation by the area. Area of the tubes is taken as X into ST. So it will become 8.8 into X into ST. So the total heat dissipation from the tank and tubes can be written as 12.5 ST plus 8.8 into X ST. That is 12.5 ST plus 8.8 X ST, which is equal to 12.5 plus 8.8 X into ST. So this is the total heat dissipation from the transformer tank and tube. So we have got the expression for total heat dissipation from the transformer tank and tubes. Total heat dissipated from the tank and tubes. So now let us calculate the equation for temperature rise. So we know that temperature rise theta is equal to Q by S lambda. So Q is the total loss in the transformer and it is the sum of iron loss and copper loss. So Q will be equal to Pi plus Pc, iron loss plus copper loss. Now what is S into lambda? Lambda is the specific heat dissipation. Heat dissipation from a unit area on the surface. So S into lambda, that is specific heat dissipation into total dissipating area, will give the total heat dissipation. Lambda is the specific heat dissipation and S into lambda is the total heat dissipation. So we have already calculated the total heat dissipation from the tank and tubes. And we have got it as 12.5 plus 8.8x into ST. So theta is equal to Pi plus Pc divided by 12.5 plus 8.8 into ST. So on rearranging this equation, we can write as 12.5 plus 8.8x is equal to Pi plus Pc divided by ST into theta. So now we have to calculate x. So this will be, we can write 8.8x will be equal to Pi plus Pc divided by ST into theta minus 12.5. So what will be the value of x? X will be equal to this into 1 divided by 8.8. So this is x. Now we have the area of tube, total area of cooling tube. Total area of tubes as x into ST. We have already defined this parameter, x into ST. So that will be equal to, this is x into ST. That is Pi plus Pc divided by ST into theta minus 12.5 into 1 divided by 8.8 into ST. So this is the answer. So we can rearrange it as 1 divided by 8.8 into, so ST and ST gets cancelled. So that term becomes Pi plus Pc divided by theta minus 12.5 into ST. 12.5 into ST. So this is the equation for area of tube, total area of the cooling tubes. So now we have to calculate the number of cooling tubes. So we can calculate the number of cooling tubes by dividing this total area of tubes by area of one tubes. Entire tubes in area namkariyam. Adine oru tube in the area kondu divide edal, we will get the number of tubes. So we know that tubes are having cylindrical shape. So let LT be the length of the tube and DT be the diameter of the tube. Then area of one tube will be equal to the surface area of a cylinder, that is pi DL. So we can write area of one tube as area of one tube. As tubes are equivalent to cylinders, are having the shape of cylinders, area of one tube will be equal to the surface area of cylinder, that is pi d into L. So here we have taken diameter as dt and length as lt. So we have 2 pi rl. Surface area of tube is, cylinder is 2 pi rl. 2 r is d. So that is how this equation came. So this is area of one tube. This is the total area of tube. Then we can calculate the number of tubes as equal to total area divided by area of one tube. Total area divided by area of one tube. So this is the total area. 1 divided by 8.8 into pi plus pc divided by theta minus 12.5 st. So this is the area of total area of the tube divided by area of one tube. Area of one tube is pi dt lt. So this is the equation for calculating the number of cooling tubes to be provided. Total area of tubes divided by area of one tube. 1 divided by 8.8 into pi dt lt into pi plus pc divided by theta minus 12.5 into st, where dt is the diameter of the tube, lt is the length of the tube, theta is the temperature difference between, sorry, the temperature rise above the ambient medium, iron loss, copper loss, and st is the surface area, dissipating surface area of the transformer tank. So this is how we can calculate the number of cooling tubes to be provided. So now we also have to look into the arrangement of cooling tubes. How these cooling tubes can be arranged over the four vertical sides of the transformer tank. So the transformer tank will look like this. So a tank will be like this. We have to arrange the tubes over the vertical sides like this. Okay, write this. Like this, we can provide the cooling tubes over the transformer tank surfaces. So while arranging the tubes, we have to keep in mind that the diameter of the tube is usually about 50 mm and center to center distance between the tubes. Between the tubes should be about a 75 mm. So while arranging the tubes over the vertical sides of the transformer, we have to keep in mind that the tubes are having a diameter of 50 mm and their center to center distance should be about 75 mm. So by knowing the length of this side and this side, this is the width of the transformer tank. By knowing WT and this is the length of the tank, LT, we can plan how to arrange the tubes over the surfaces. So this is all about the design of transformer tank with the tubes.